Now, continuing on, here we have the file for the magistrate table. Enable section view will create a section view of this model, which we have now included. Typically, if you want to go and cut some section, or maybe cut this section and then this area, we can use the enable section. You can click the enable section view too. If it gives you the full files or the overall files, it means that it's this and enable. Or disable. Sorry. Now enable again. Here it will show you the planes, alignment custom, link planes, and the current plane. So let's set it as plane 1. And let's select the alignment as top. Means it's showing the alignment from top, and you can cut it from top going down. So to show the current plane or this plane, let's select move. It will show you the, once you select the move, once you select, it will show you this arrow, and this is the plane. This is the cutting plane. You can either shift once this arrow is pointing upwards. We have three arrows. One is moving from horizontally, and another one is on the X and Y axis. Another one is the Z axis, which you can cut the plane downward, or you can cut the plane upwards. So that is how we cut the plane or the sections and use in this current plane. So you can go through the floor until you reach the last floor, and there it goes up. We can cut it vertically. What we need, its current alignment is on top. Let's set it top as front. We're just following this blueprint. It should be set on this side. So we set it as front. It will change. Now it's the position of the plane is on the front, following this front view. You can either select the X and Y. You can shift it which location you want to cut, or which vertically position or Y position. As long as it falls within this square box, that is the view that you will see. If this is the boundary of the view that you will see from this camera. So here you can cut it. Go inwards and you can cut the view, and then reposition the view cube so you can see it's much more clearly and can see some profile. So that is how to cut a section using the current plane and setting it into a position that you would like to cut it. Another position, let's say, is the right or left. Let's say right. It will change the position to the right side. Again, you can X and Y, and then you can cut, move the cutting position. Now, each current plane, you can say, let's say we set current plane as right. Now let's go to plane 2 and let's set the plane 2 as top. So now we have the top position. We can combine the current plane and the top plane. So now we have the top plane. We can shift it up and down. We can combine using the current plane 1, and then from that cutting position we can also cut another position using the current plane top. We can move downward or we can move up. Now let's set this as top, current plane 2. Now let's go to current plane 2. Let's shift it up and let's use it as front. Let's see where it is. Okay, so now we can move it again. We can move the front, position it to where you want to place your view. So that is how to set the position of the current plane. Now we go to current plane 4. Let's set it as another view, which is the back, which is quite nice, just nice. So this is the back view. You can shift it again, move and shift and cut to the position you prefer. Now here we skip this command, unselect the move. Hide this, And once you set again to plane one, it will go back to that cutting position, which is the right position. Once you select the move, the boundary and the arrows will show up again in this position. So it follows whatever display you have now. Once you can add in the current plane, it will automatically add the cutting plane into this view or display that we have currently. So let's go to into, which supposed to have the top view cut, so you can position it and then cut it up. So once you have set this, then you can just use the current plane here rather than assigning it again one by one using this alignment. So that is how to use the current plane. Set the current plane 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now another setting is the view or the box plane. Here the box plane, you can set the plane of the whole building. It shows the cube. You can set the plane downward. This is the whole box. You can actually cut the box here. And you make it smaller to cut the plane into position. This is another way of cutting the section. If you want to see the whole section, you can push it in and you can move it. This is a more in a more bigger display. You can set all the views and cut a position within a box boundary position. So the first one is for the each plane. Now you can have all the planes shown, either left or right, back and front. You can see all the position and the cutting section. You can go up and down. Again, we have, aside from that, we can move, we can rotate. Actually here we can rotate this position. Once the yellow line, you can rotate the box to see it in an inclined plane or whichever plane you want to rotate. Here we just rotate it here. So you can cut at an angle view. Now you can also scale, since it will make the box bigger, so you will have more items or objects that they can be captured in your view. Then fit selection, it will fit whatever items in this selection within that box. So that is how to use the view enable section view tool in viewpoint command or ribbon. So let's go back to the save manage viewpoint. And then you can use to enable the section view and use either plane or box selection as section mode. So you can cut a section using plane and box and using the current plane 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and 6. Okay.